So in a previous video, I talked about fixed voltage regulators that take an unregulated voltage on the input and spit out a tightly regulated voltage on the output. For example, the popular 7805 is used to create a constant 5-volt supply. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the LM317 adjustable voltage regulator to create any regulated voltage you want, all the way up to 37 volts. You could use it as a power supply for a lot of projects, such as a fan speed controller. You can get an LM317 from anywhere that sells electronics. Sometimes they're called LM317T or LM317AT. Once you've got it, put a heatsink on it so it doesn't melt your breadboard. The next thing to do is put a couple of capacitors on the input and output pins. Put a 0.1 microfarad ceramic capacitor on the input and a 1 microfarad electrolytic capacitor on the output. Remember to use caps rated higher than the voltages that you're working with. If you want to use more capacitance, that's fine too. These capacitors aren't always necessary, but putting them in there guarantees that the output voltage will be stable in almost any situation. Next, we set the output voltage using two resistors labeled R1 and R2. You can use this equation to figure out the output voltage. But to start out with, I'll show you the quick and easy way to use an LM317. Let's make R1 510 ohms, and let's use a 10 kiloohm variable resistor for R2. Doing this gives us a constant voltage supply that we can adjust from 1.25 volts to 25 volts. But remember, your input voltage needs to be at least 2 or 3 volts higher than the output voltage, otherwise the output voltage is limited. For example, here I have a 12 volt lead acid battery, and it's charged up to 13.5 volts. When I use it to power my adjustable regulator, I can get an output range from 1.25 volts to 12.4 volts when it's under a small load. The headroom I need is called the dropout voltage, and it will always be given in the datasheet. So anyway, this is a very common way to make an adjustable fan speed controller, or test circuits at different operating voltages, or see how many volts it takes to blow something up. Alright, now let's say you don't want to use a potentiometer. You just want a fixed voltage using two resistors. Here's the formula I showed you earlier. If you're curious about how the equation is derived, read the LM317 datasheets from National Semiconductor and Texas Instruments. In order to simplify the equation, let's pick a value for R2. Let's make it 4.7 kiloohms, and now the equation becomes much easier. Next, you can rearrange the equation like this. Now you can find out the value of R1 based on the output voltage that you want. For example, let's say you wanted a 9-volt output. Plugging that into the equation gives you R1 equals 782 ohms, and R2 is still the 4.7 kiloohms we chose. So I put a 680 ohm resistor in series with a 100 ohm resistor, which gave me 780 ohms, and that was close enough to give me 9 volts. Finally, let's talk about wasted heat. The LM317 is a linear voltage regulator, and the efficiency equations are exactly the same as the 7805s. The bigger the difference between the input voltage and the output voltage, the more heat gets produced. So let's say you have your output set to 6 volts, so you can get more speed and torque out of a servo. And let's power it from a nickel metal hydride battery charged to 8.4 volts. And let's say the servo draws 1 amp. The heat generated in the LM317 would be 2.4 watts. Now, if you were to power the LM317 from a higher voltage source, like a lead acid battery charged to 13.8 volts, all of a sudden things get a lot hotter. 7.8 watts is a lot of heat that you'll have to dissipate, so you should try to keep your input and output voltages fairly close to each other if you expect to be drawing a significant amount of current. And that's it! Check out my other videos to learn more about other electronic components.